I'm Sarah from PHLster, and today we're going to talk about how to use the poke and check method to get better concealment. You might be familiar with this technique already from adjusting your Enigma, but you can also use it to improve your concealment with a regular belt holster as well. Poke and check is exactly as simple as it sounds. You just push on the gun, poke it, and check what effect it has. The goal is to eliminate any printing, which is when the outline of your gun shows through your clothing, and to get to your maximum concealment potential. That's when you get the exact right balance of adjustments to get the best possible concealment you can get with that gun. This video assumes you've already found your concealment sweet spot, which is the ideal spot on your body for the gun. You want to find your sweet spot first because you'll need different adjustments for different positions on the body. So you don't want to go all the way through your adjustments only to realize you're not in quite the right spot. We've got a whole separate video for finding your sweet spot, so be sure to check that one out if you haven't already. Once you've found your sweet spot, put your gun on and make note of any printing or trouble spots. For example, you can see that right now, the grip of my gun is printing. So to do the poke and check, I push in on any areas of printing, and then I observe what happens. So you can see if I push the grip of my gun in like this, if I could just get a little more grip rotation, I'd have way better concealment. And now you can see here, my slide is printing. If I could just get the slide to tuck in more, I'd get better concealment. By using the poke and check method to move the gun, I can make the gun conform to the ideal spot on my body. So think of it like you're moving the gun freely in 3D space. Once you know exactly where it needs to be, you can use the concealment mechanics to make it stay there. Concealment mechanics are a set of basic physics principles that help us move the gun on the body and keep it where we want it, while maintaining stability and access to the grip. So for example, I know from the poke and check method that pressing in on my slide gives me better concealment, but I can't stand there and press in on my slide all day. And I don't want to just put something over my slide to keep it pressed in because then I wouldn't be able to draw the gun. So the concealment mechanics are the physics principles we apply to the holster shell to influence the position of the gun without restricting access to it. There are three main tools in our toolbox here, and those are wings, wedges, and belt pressure. Belt pressure is really the foundation of everything. Without pressure on the outer face of the gun, there's obviously nothing holding the gun to the body at all, and it'll just fall off. Using a belt or an Enigma over the holster shell gives us pressure over the face of the holster that pulls the gun in towards the body. But belt pressure all by itself is a really coarse tool, and we can actually use the other concealment tools to control and to sculpt that pressure and direct the gun to move it exactly where we want it to stay. A wing is a device that goes on the holster and makes the grip of the gun rotate in towards the body. So it rotates the gun mostly in this plane. A wedge goes between the holster and the body, and it has a little more complicated effect. The most basic thing it does is tuck the top of the gun in towards the body. So it moves the gun mostly in this plane. But depending on your body shape and where you place the wedge, it can give you very precise control over the position of the gun. We've got a whole separate video on wedges, so you can check that one out too. So those three tools together are the basic building blocks of good concealment. Okay, back to the poke and check. You can see that when I push my grip in, it reduces printing in that area. But take a look at the other effects it has too. When I push the grip in, the bottom of the gun goes out, and there's a little bit of a gap there between my body and the gun. So let's actually look at that in reverse. By controlling the position of the muzzle of the gun, I can change where I want the grip to go without blocking access to the grip. So if the poke and check tells me I need a little more grip tuck, I can place a muzzle wedge behind my gun to fill in the gap there, and then when I tighten my belt over the whole thing, the belt pressure is sculpted around the wing and the wedge, and it makes my grip tuck more. So between belt pressure, wedges, and wings, we can remove any trouble spots that are causing the gun to print. But what if I don't have any major trouble spots? What if the entire thickness of the gun is the problem? So what if it's basically adding bulk to the waistline or creating a shelf where the top of my shirt hits the gun here and kind of creates this little ledge. Now what? Well, in that case, the best solution is to fine-tune your sweet spot if you can, if you have room to do that. If you can get the gun off of your peaks and into your valleys, like we talk about in the sweet spot video, that helps minimize the perception of extra bulk. But aside from that, the thickness of the gun is pretty much a constant, so the only real way to change that is to carry a thinner gun or to tighten the belt to the point where the gun actually starts to squish into your soft tissue, which works, but it's not really the greatest solution. Overly tight belts can actually be painful and they can be bad for your health. Plus, it's just physics that if you tighten your belt enough to squish the gun in, then the amount of belt pressure that's gonna take is gonna actually give you muffin top. So either way, you're gonna have to dress around something. You gotta kind of pick and choose. You can use the poke and check method to experiment with your wing and your wedge and get to your maximum concealment potential with the gun. That's when your concealment is maxed out and it can't get any better with that particular gun. So you'll know when you're at your maximum concealment potential because every time you try to make a change in one area, you can't really get it better without sacrificing another area. All of the changes that we're making are related and they all work together. Concealment is kind of a balancing act, and when you start to experiment with it, you'll find the best balance point for your body. For example, my magazine is printing slightly here, but when I press in to make it tuck more, I start to lose concealment in other areas. It's a balancing act, so I have to choose which effect is most important for my overall concealment goals, and that can change from person to person and even from outfit to outfit. The nice thing though is that the poke and check allows you to be adaptable because you can self-assess and improve your concealment pretty much any time. It just takes a couple minutes. The last thing to cover here is realistic expectations. Remember that your gun prints when it encounters the outer envelope of your clothing. If it's completely within the empty space between your clothing and your body, it's concealed. If it hits the clothing envelope, it's going to print. That means if you're at your maximum concealment potential and you've wrung every last drop of concealment out of that gun and it still prints, then the only real option is to increase the envelope of your clothing. You can do that by making tweaks to your wardrobe, and if you do, I'd recommend checking out the YouTube channel Armed and Styled. She's got some really helpful videos on things like how fabric choices affect concealment for both men and women. Quick review. Poke your gun, check the effect, and use the concealment mechanics to get your gun to stay where you want it. If you want more concealment tips, check out the PHLster website at PHLsterHolsters.com.